Good morning, everyone. My name is Nirupama, and on behalf of the Faculty of School of Architecture and Interior Design, I extend a very warm welcome to all of you to day one of the orientation program. We are as excited as I'm sure you all are to have you on board with us. Without further ado, I welcome our Dean, Dr. P. Satish Kumar, to address the group.
Very good morning, everybody, my dear students. Thank you so much for the year coordinators and everybody who has given the opportunity. A special thanks to Almighty. And I personally feel, you know, this kind of orientation is very important, especially for the course like architecture, for a simple reason that you are definitely different. Different in the sense, not only in terms of where you look at things or you understand things, in terms of everything, the way you conduct yourself, the way you understand yourself, the way you live, the way you create and everything. So this is a process which we are trying to make, and best wishes for everybody who has made this possible. First, thanks to the Almighty, thanks to the parents, thanks for everything, especially thanks to the teachers here and all the students here who is getting benefited and sharing that to everybody here. And the whole idea of doing this kind of orientation, apart from other things, is to do a lot of unlearning process, because you have come out with maths, physics, chemistry. And what we talk is about something called creativity. And I'm sure most of you are very good creative in thinking. And we would like to do the unlearning process. Just to tell you simple, in a simple way, 1 + 1 is not equal to 2. Maybe sounds different for you, but still that's the fact. Because 80 of your classmates may give you 80 different designs and may not be alike. So, for which first you should do this unlearning process of understanding 1 + 1 is not equal. Even a scientist will say that very clearly. One male dog and one female dog is not equal to 2 dogs. Maybe many dogs. So, like that, as an architect, you should really understand. No, and not only in terms of anything you understand or you create it, you should think it in a kind of out of box context, because you are different and you are special. That's why you are here, and you are not doing any mathematics. Or you are not doing any something called mechanically. This is what, or you're not equal. Always keep yourself very happy and comfortable. Healthy mind, healthy body, and healthy performance. And everything will come very happy, very happily. It's a joy, it's a josh. You know, do things with the utmost comfort. And whatever you think in a very disciplined format, in a very good way, do it very confidently, do boldly. And see to that it doesn't go out of line and out of track. So that this discipline is very, very important in anything you think and do. And coming back to the campus, we have a very excellent campus. And very good environment in terms of all infrastructure and quality facilities, like your bus, your hostel, and other supports, whatever you need. Everything is well provided. You know very well, our campus is about 250 acres. And we have almost all the courses except a veterinary course in our university. And talking about our college in this university, we also have a very excellent faculty members, very friendly, very comfortable, professional, very round architects, and more prescribed by the Council of Architecture norms and regulations. And most of them are postgraduate, or almost all of them are postgraduate, except one or two they are also pursuing. And most of them are doing the doctoral degree program, except one or two is already in doctorates here. And we have a very good faculty-student relationship. And we mostly be very friendly with everybody, not only the students, not only the faculty, and anybody for that sake. Because that is how our teachers have taught us, and our environment has taught us, and we practice that also. And we live a very comfortable and very happy life. So, like it is not just a course, it's a way of living. No, you go along with that, you live like that. The whole life, it is with fun, joy, and happiness. No, you feel very comfortable, and you'll be very different, and you're very creative. And we also appreciate and encourage a lot of students, faculty interactions. Let us be like brothers and sisters, friends, and no family, whatever you call, let's have a very good bonding. Let's travel through the life. This is what I also personally expect along with my faculty team. And now we are all together. And we always call about SAP semester after program. Some people may wonder what is called a semester after program. Now you are in the first semester of first year BR. Probably when you complete your second semester or by the end of the second semester, you will be given opportunity by the university, by the institutions, by the coordinators to go abroad in the third semester, either to National University of Singapore or MIT or Harvard or any other universities you prefer, such as where we have signed an MOU with those universities. That is, we have signed an MOU with about 150 universities in the country, in the world. And also, we have signed a few MOUs with other different countries like IIT Mumbai and few other universities in the pipeline. You can also go there and do your one semester or two semester also. So for which your marks, your credentials should support, right? So whoever comes forward to do your undergraduate, probably one or two semesters abroad, is called as semester abroad program. So we have that facilities also. The faculties may also join along with you if required. The students is permitted, and we will add that those credentials here also. So you take that, and that is a part of this academics. That is one good thing which is not available in many universities. We have that. We definitely, apart from the being very friendly with the students and other things, we also have the international tours, because this study itself is not in the studios and classrooms and lecture halls. It's mostly of your travel. You travel across the country, across the world, see many things. You read, you learn, you understand, you write, you photograph, you discuss, you interact. A lot of things is a good learning process. As a creator, it comes to you. And we take you across the world and travel across the whole of this 5 years. As much as possible in terms of the basic design or a rural design or a aquatic design or... We travel as possible. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So, we travel as much as possible and we understand many things and be a very good creator. And also that, along with that, we do a lot of teamwork. Work with your classmates, work with the teachers, work with the seniors, work with the juniors, work with the society, work with the fraternity, work with the professionals. And that gives a very good strength and confidence, and you are definitely going to be superb and excellent because the course itself is like that. And we also have a lot of good industrial institution connect, because when the process, probably you have been trained in the orientation programs and earlier programs before you join the institutions, you would have bought a lot of different experts, architectural professionals across the country. Even the due course, probably you will see hundreds of professionals coming and interacting with you. This may or may not happen in any different places, but here it happens. Mostly, I also strongly believe that education is that. Just have more of interaction, just shake hands with them, just travel, just learn from our seniors, elders, professionals. And we have a lot of good international industrial connect. And along with that, we also have a very good alumni connect, because your seniors who has passed out also will support you, and they may take you for your training and internship, or even they may place you. And they may also support you in different programs. They may also be your expert along with you. They may also be part of your thesis, and more of other combinations will be there. And always they will shake hands and take care of you. But now you just see, apart from the Almighty who is always with us, your parents are there, your teachers are there, your friends are there, your classmates are there, your seniors and juniors are going to be there, will always be there. And the alumni connect, the industry connect, so much of people are there with you. And you're becoming more stronger and more good creator, and you'll definitely become a Brahma or a creator or a Vishwakarma or whatever you call. And you feel so alight and so comfortable. It all be more elegant and perfectly sounds better if you maintain the discipline along with you. Thank you so much and do well. All the best. God bless you.
Thank you, sir. Next, I'd like to invite Professor Esther, our admin coordinator, to address the group.
A very good morning to all the students and the faculties present here. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome all the students to our School of Architecture and Interior Design. As our Dean, Dr. P. Satish Kumar sir, has given an overall picture of the School of Architecture and how your journey for the next 5 years would be, I would like to touch upon the Semester Abroad program, especially being the coordinator for SAP. I would tell you this is a very special initiative which is taken by our SRM Institute of Science and Technology. SAP is offered to the UG students after they complete 2 semesters in the campus, and for PG students after they complete 10 months in the campus. So after you complete 2 years in UG, you'll be eligible to go for the semester abroad program. So you can find out which university interests you or your area of interest. You can link the subjects which you are going to take the next semester in your foreign university and map it with the home university and do the same in the foreign university. So your credits will be transferred in the foreign university you do to the credits which we offer here in-house. So this would how the semester abroad program would work. And with regards to finding out the university, we are here to help you as a team and identify the university of your interest. SRM has a number of universities which MOU has been signed with. And even if you do not find your college of interest in that particular university, you can go ahead and identify any university you want, and SRM can facilitate the semester abroad program with that particular university. So we have the opportunities and tie-ups to establish connect with any place that you want to go and establish your semester abroad program. This semester abroad program will help you understand what the foreign opportunities are or how the programs are being offered, and you can come back and reflect the same in them. We also have dual course programs and twinning degree programs which is offered, which we will tell you in detail once you step into the entire program. As in when you need any suggestions or requirements, please feel free to contact us. Thank you, Professor Nirupama ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Next up, let us get introduced to the faculty teams. Let us start with the first year BArch and BDiz faculty team. Now I invite Professor Geeta to introduce herself.
Hi everybody, I'm Professor K. Geeta Ramesh. I'll be the design advisor for first years, and I have been working here at SRM since 2005. I completed my undergraduate from Anna University School of Architecture and Planning in the year 1995. And I was in industry for a period of 7 years, working in Rajendran Associates for 4 years, after which I had taken freelancing works for a period of 3 years. And then I started my PG in the year 2002 and completed the same in 2004 from the same college, School of Architecture and Planning, Anna University. Now, currently I'm pursuing PhD and in the verge of completion of it. And my area of research is on daylighting. So I don't want to take much time of yours. I would like to mention that I'll be handling mathematics for architecture for first year BArch students and basic design as well. So we will meet then later. Thank you and all the best. May God bless you all.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Now I invite Professor Narayani, the first year year coordinator and also our academic coordinator, to introduce herself.
Thank you, Nirupama. Welcome to all the faculty, the members present here and the students. I am very honored to be here in front of you today for one special reason, that I am an alumni of this institute. I've seen this institute as a student, as a faculty, and now the academic coordinator of the department. So it is a great honor and it's a privilege to be in this university. Apart from that, I think we have already discussed about how the student life is. This is a class apart from all other universities that you would have seen or visited. And the kind of exposure that this institute gives to us is enormous. The management support is also enormous for us. The kind of coursework, the kind of faculty interactions you have here, the connect that we can establish with each other is completely different. I hope you experience that forum, as and when we have also scheduled a very interesting sessions for the next 15 days for all of you to interact with us and, you know, break the ice, like we say. Since you are the first batch of students who are getting into the digital era or the digital learning programs, we are also thrilled to see how this whole process turns out to be. So all the very best and see you soon.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I invite Professor Karthik to introduce himself.
Hi, student. Myself, Karthik. I am an assistant professor in SRM IST. I joined SRM in 2018, Kattangulpur campus. I will be handling architectural graphics and basic design for you for this talk. So we'll make your both communication.
Thank you, sir. Next, I invite Professor Suraj to introduce himself.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes, yes, we can.
Okay. Hello, hi, students. Good morning to everyone. I am architect Suraj Dwivedi. I studied architecture from Gujarat. I passed out in 2014. And after that, I started practicing. I came to South of India in Auroville. In 2.5 years, I think now. And I will be your first year, I will be teaching art studio this semester and architectural graphics. And I will be showing you some freehand and digital delineations. So we're going to have lots of fun. It's a lot of art and architecture mixed together. And I conduct a lot of workshops as I believe in teaching with hands-on and not just theoretical data. So can't wait to meet you guys in the class and very excited for it. Welcome everyone and all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Suraj. We also have Professor Kamala Kannan sir in our team, but unfortunately he's not been able to join us today. So I will give a brief introduction about him. He is a senior faculty and he's been with us for about 30 years. He's got more than 30 years of experience and he'll be handling a history of architecture this semester for the BR. And also being a part of the first year faculty team, I shall introduce myself. My name is Nirupama and I'm a visiting faculty member at SRE. I graduated from VRC Academy of Architecture and have worked with a couple of architecture firms in Chennai. Today, I continue to practice as a freelancer, aside from teaching at SRM, and my interests include sustainable design and interior design. Besides, I also enjoy doing Kerala mural painting and art and craft of any form. And this semester, I'll be handling basic design, art studio, and also an elective subject called evolution of classical interiors. So looking forward for the classes. All the best, everyone. And next, we'll have the first year BRIS faculty team introducing. And can we have Professor Susheta to introduce herself?
Good morning, all. I'm Susheta, first year year coordinator. So I have completed MSA, MPhil, and MPA, and then pursuing PhD in role of crafts in interior design. I have been here for 13 years. And handling various subjects like basic design, other studio courses, and theory courses like lighting and color, and contemporary interior designers, textile design, and various papers I'm handling for the VDES program. Before that, I would like to express the value of the interior design course because many students call me and ask me about the career options. So what is interior design? Interior design program emphasizing design that brings meaning and identity, function and purpose, healthy and safety to the interior spaces. The program teaches a specialized knowledge in creative problem solving, research and analysis, and professional preparedness. And interior designers give life to interior spaces. They shape, organize, furnish, and adorn the insides of buildings to reflect our personal and cultural aspirations. So as a designers, what you have to develop the qualities like artistic ability, creativity, detail oriented, interpersonal skills, and problem solving skills, and visualization. Then this design school graduates have many career options. They are just a few areas of focus that it could be a universal designers, sustainable designers, kitchen and bath designer, a lighting designer, then color consultant and furniture designer, etc. So these are the various career options for interior design students. So here we are here to support you every step of the way in your journey to the graduate stage. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I invite Professor Abhinaya to introduce herself.
Good morning, all. Myself, T.L. Abhinaya. I'm assistant professor at the School of Architecture and Interior Design. I have done my construction management. So I'm SRM alumni. So since 2016, I'm working here as assistant professor. And I will be handling a BDES design for first year students and also the project management for all the BDES students. So welcome you all to the SRM group. We'll see you soon. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Can we have Professor Harish next? Professor Harish, we're not able to hear you.
Yes, this is Hari, and I've done my bachelor's from Crescent, and I've done my master's in interior architecture and design from CEP University. And I've been associated with SRM since 6 months, and it's been good experience working here, and you get to meet a lot of new minds and different sets. So I'm looking forward to explore this thing with you guys, waiting for you guys to be on board. Thank you. Thank you, Nirupama.
Thank you, Professor Harish. Now I'd like to invite our PG coordinator, Professor Aravind, to introduce the MARC and MBES faculty team.
Thank you, Professor Nirupama. Good morning to everyone. Welcome to one of the best universities in the globe, SRMIT. And I'm really proud and glad to share the, one of the information in PG coordinator capacity that we here at SRM IST is one of the universities with approved from COA for PG studies in the way back in the year 2006. So we had almost 12 batches as now with rich experience. And as other faculty, my colleagues have been insisting on, the unique feature about SRM University or SRM Institute of Science and Technology is the semester abroad program, one of a very unique feature. And I would request all the UG and PG faculty, UG and PG students to make use of this opportunity of doing your abroad studies for a semester or two based on your eligibility. If you can say PG, 10 months you should have completed, at least 2 semesters. So it gives you eligibility for you to go abroad in the third semester. This curriculum has been designed in such a way it will facilitate you. And we insist that most of our students or almost all the students to go and do their semester abroad program in the third semester for PG students. And you will have benefit of getting dual degrees. The universities wherever you have, you can explore. So this one unique feature I would definitely insist upon in the benefit what as a student you will get in SRM IST. And other features, like we have near about 50 scholars who are doing their research. So definitely it goes without saying the advantage what PG students and UG students with this 50 scholars, PhD scholars to be very precise, they are pursuing a research program in SRM IST. Katanuthur campus. So these are a few points which I would like to highlight upon. Will definitely have a direct benefit to you, both UG and PG students. Now I introduce Professor Naubardi, the first year coordinator, to come forward and introduce herself.
Good morning, all. Good morning, everyone. It's good to see all the new faces here, and we are very happy to see you all. I am Navabharati, an assistant professor from SRM and also the MOC first year year coordinator. And I have done my BR in Prime College and my master's is in SPA Bhopal with the specialization of urban and regional planning. So my area of interest are peri-urbanization, suburban areas and affordable housing. And I welcome you all for your next step in your academic career. and you have embarked with the advanced educational system as of now in this digital educational mode. And I wish you all succeed and come out with the flying colors. And hereby I introduce our PG faculty team of FEMA first year. So I request Dr. Shanti Priya ma'am to introduce herself.
Very good morning to one and all. We welcome you all to the SIRM family. We welcome you to our home. I am Dr. Shanti Priya, almost in academics for about nearly 20 years. And my highest qualification is PhD from Anna University, Chennai. And I specialize in the area of building science. And I am here to initiate lots of research activities in the department. Starting centers for excellence in architectural education and centers for excellence in other domains also. I'm here. I'm also guiding research scholars in SIRM University. I'm also handling one subject in first year, which is standards and legal framework for urban infrastructure planning and management. So let's have a nice time together. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request Dr. Syed sir to introduce himself.
Hello everyone, this is Syed. I'm a civil engineer by profession. I've done my bachelor's from College of Engineering, Indy, master's from Tyagaraja, and PhD from NIT Jaipur. I'm here as a part of the research team here. I'll also be handling this theory course in the first semester with the title Long Span Structures for Architectural Purposes. Looking forward to be meeting you today. Have a good day.
Thank you, sir. Now I request Professor Yamini ma'am to introduce herself.
Yeah, hi, good morning to one and all. A warm welcome to new joinees from SIRM School of Architecture and Interior Design. I'm Yamini, Associate Professor, presently handling MR second year. I have completed my graduation from Madras University and PhD from Anna University. I've got about 15 plus years of experience in both the professional and teaching areas with core area in sustainability. As conveyed by PG coordinator, students, I assure that this is going to be one of the best times in your academic career, as you have joined one of the best institutions where your academic excellence, you are going to have a holistic development. But with this privilege comes a responsibility as well, a responsibility to work hard, a responsibility to conduct yourself wherever you are as a member of one of the distinguished SIRM family, a responsibility of being a source of inspirations to your friends. And you should also become a role model to your juniors. I take immense pleasure in welcoming you all. Looking forward to see you all in the class. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request Professor Bala Maheshwaran sir to introduce himself.
Good morning, students, and good morning, my dear colleagues. I'm happy to be on this day welcoming my fellow juniors, because even I am an alumni of SIRM family. So I did both my bachelor's and master's from this institute. Very semester abroad program, which most of your faculties are advocating. I am an example of that particular program, where I got an opportunity to travel to France. And I did my second master's there on urban and regional planning. Post which I came back and started my architectural practice here. And I was also working with other institutes as assistant professor. And I have completed my PhD coursework from SEPT University. Now I have transferred my credits to NIT Trichy. So I'm a research scholar who's associated with NIT Trichy at this point. So it gives me a great pleasure to see young minds who are enrolling in SIRM for a great future. So I welcome all. For MR first year, I will be handling Advanced Computer Studio. And my expertise lies in digital architecture and experience design. So anybody who is interested in this line of research field can kindly get in touch with me. We shall see what we can do. Maybe we can write a few papers together, or we can explore different trajectories along those lines. So it gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all. Have a happy learning here. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Now I request Professor Shukeshini ma'am to introduce herself.
Good morning to everyone. So I congratulate all students for being yourself in this premier institute. I completed my UG program from Periyar Manyam University, and I did my master's in banking. And I am going to handle advanced computer students for first year MA students. And I encourage each of these students to take advantage of SR University's position and explore yourself to grow higher and bigger. All the best. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I request Professor Prashantini, ma'am, to introduce us.
A very good morning to everyone here. And a very warm welcome and congratulations for choosing this institute. I'm Prashantini Rajagopal, and I underwent my undergraduation and post-graduation from National Institute of Technology, Trichapalli. And I'm currently undergoing my PhD studies. My specialization is in energy efficient and sustainable architecture. With my PhD studies, I am now focusing my energy into urban heat islands. I'll be taking first year MArk students Urban Design and Design Studio 1. And we have a very enriching program waiting for you. And I'm very looking forward to seeing you all very soon. So have a really good and wish you all the best.
Thank you, ma'am. And at last, myself, Professor Navbharati, I'll be handling one of the elective subjects, which is sustainable development and technology for MArk first year. And I want to introduce the design faculties, Professor Arvind Sir, the design in charge, and Professor Prashantini ma'am, and myself, we three are your design faculties. Thank you, all the faculties. Arvind Sir. Oh,
thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Now I request Professor Sarvagata Sir, our guest coordinator, to come forward and introduce himself and the team.
Dear all, happy to welcome you all and congratulate you the first chance to share your valuable one, most important part of your life. And my name is R. Saravaraja, and I have completed my MIT architecture from NIT Sachi and my master's NDS from IIT Bombay. Currently, I am pursuing my PhD in NIT Sachi, and I'll be handling the NDS first years. And we have our other faculties, Professor Maithili and Professor Vallabha. I hope we all gathered here for academics, education, knowledge, and teaching, but college life is not just academics. There is no shortcut for success, so don't rush. Learning and gaining knowledge is not a race. Get it in your own pace and take your time and enjoy the learning process by exploring your ideas, who you are, what you want. And best wishes and congratulations once again to share your valuable part of life with us. And I would like to introduce our MDS faculties now. And now I request Professor Vallabha to say a few words to the news.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Shri Vallabha. I have done my undergraduation from Sussex Graduate School of Architecture, Bihar, and my post-graduation from Sepi University, MDS in Interior Design. I have joined the team of SRM 16 months now. I take immense pleasure in welcoming you all and looking forward to seeing you. All the very best and explore and enjoy the journey here. Thank you.
And now I request Professor Maithili to have a few words with us.
Hi all. First of all, a very big welcome to all of you. Congrats for joining the PG and the UG program. And I'm Maitri. I'm joined as an assistant professor in SRM. I've done my UG from Ahmed Siddha KJ Academy of Architecture and my PG from SEPT University, Masters in Design, Interior Design. And I wish you all the best for the journey ahead. Have learning with fun. Have a lot of fun. Enjoy your life, because this opportunity, each of you are going to get only once in your life. Make the best out of it. Have a nice, exciting journey ahead. All the best to all. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. Over to Professor Nirupama.
Thank you to the entire first year faculty team. That was a lovely introduction and a beautiful welcome note to the students. Now, I request Professor Abhinaya to give a brief introduction of our guest of the day.
Good morning, students. I'm happy to introduce our special invitee, Dr. Andalyn Diana Phillips.
She serves in a trio capacity at SRM. She is an assistant professor in the Department of English and Foreign Language, executive assistant to the Vice Chancellor and Manager Faculty Personnel. She has more than a decade of experience in teaching and training pupils and half a decade of experience in administration. She keeps herself active to new learning and particularly engaging in research. She was awarded silver medal twice for her research papers in 2013 and 2014. She is well known for her poetry and presentation skills. Recently, she was appreciated for one of her poems titled The Mighty PhD. She also conducts English language training program and skill programs for schools and various colleges. She is the director of Philemus programs, and through this she offered free training section to the marginalized section of our society regularly. She excels in art and craft, calligraphy, and has authored 3 books. She has presented and published paper in various conferences and journals. She envisioned life by the tagline, "Be a superstar in your own way." Now I call upon Dr. Andalyn Diana Philemus to address the gathering.
Hello, everybody. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. You're audible.
So, respected students, parents, friends of media and press, colleagues, and all well-wishers gathered here, good morning to one and all. I am a proud alumna of SRM University. Years back, I did one of my masters here and my PhD. Today, SRM is my second home. It's a place where I work, and I always carry a very proud feeling of my alma mater. I feel very, very involved in being a member of the SRM family. And I take this opportunity to welcome you all to this great family. SRM is magic, truly. It's magic to all those who try to learn the tricks of the magic that is available here. The tricks I refer to here are the various opportunities, the different cultures, the type of people, the type of networking, everything SRM gives you in this one big banner. And I would like to share with you that in my career track, I've stayed the longest with SRM, and I hope it remains the same. So my dear students, if I may, with your permission, call you young achievers. Each of you are young achievers here. You are going to make things happen in a very big way. You are bodies of achievement. This is how I look at you. And each of us aspire to have a career. We are busy building our career lives, right? And we sometimes take the extra mile, a lot of hard work, a lot of toiling to make a difference in our career path. But just stop by and think whether you are taking the right effort in the right directions. This one thought will actually divert you, or rather take you to the right vision which you have in mind. I truly hope you have chosen this course out of your own free will. And well, if it's the other way around, never worry about it. You are here for a reason. You are here for a mission, right? So let it all happen through your course, but eventually try to make yourself happy by building a name for yourself. Try to engage in everything possible that SRM offers to you. I would like to share with you that when I was in school, maybe even in my college days, we had something called as the goodbye book. A kind of book where you give to your friends and classmates, and the first thing we ask them to fill is their name, date of birth, favorite color, favorite food, you know, the best place we met, etc., etc., choices. And trust me, those books are still with me, but I fail to network with them, right? It's just like a traditional thing which I did. And I also realized that when I gave the goodbye book in school, in class 12, I couldn't actually get a good collection of memories from all my classmates and batchmates, because I seem to have had a very closed circle in school. And my goodbye diary or goodbye book has a very selective kind of people who I really associated with. I think this is something which I should not have done. even today at this point in my life, I know my classmates, but I fail to have that interconnected bond with them. Well, in school, I would have had 100,000 opportunities to network, to learn from them, to mingle with them, etc. So I strongly recommend you to network with all your classmates, all your batchmates, know them by name, know them for their skill. Ultimately, the entire lot of you, the young achievers, you will all have your degrees by God's grace in a matter of 4 to 5 years. But what you have different from the other really does matter. Remember, the person sitting next to you may be your classmate, may be your batchmate today, but eventually in the job market, in the demanding world, the same person, you know, would be a competitor. So always try to explore the opportunities. And in school, I had multiple opportunities to learn different languages, to learn different forms of dance, particularly Bharatanatyam, and everything there. Even in colleges, I did have in my various courses, but I never opted for it. But today, I share with you a personal encounter where I now have a desire that I should have learned dance. I should have, you know, practiced these kind of things from these kind of girls and boys, whoever I actually had an interaction with. But today, life demands different things. You need a specific time slot to it. You need to dedicate your body, which when you start working, you are no more flexible as how you are as a young achiever, right? So what I'm saying is do it young. It's easier, and your student life can offer you a lot of support to it. Whereas once you start into a career growth or your career, you know, your job, you may not have time to build your passion. And vice versa, I should have actually shared my calligraphy skills, my emceeing skills, my art and craft skills to my batchmates as well. So I'd be remembered in their lives. They will remember me for teaching them that particular skill. So these are the things which I failed to do in school, but I actually compensated a bit of it in my college. And I shared this tip with you. If you know something, share it with somebody, teach them for it, because they'll remember you for teaching them, right? And it's always nice to be remembered by people for something unique or something special or a skill, right? So you will live in memory. Our lives are today here and tomorrow we are gone, but the memories of us can remain on this earth. So how do you do that? Network with people, teach them what you know, learn what you do not know, network with different types of people. Don't look for only similar type. Normally, if I may say, when you make friends or when you fall in love, we look for similarities. But similarities are fine to a certain extent. But the differences, that's what makes it more unique, makes your relationships more special, right? So explore the differences. And I'm so happy that I was here to listen to some of the professors who introduced themselves. And along with it, they shared with you their areas of expertise. So you should actually knock out the potential of the various faculties available in the campus. Your own friends may have some great potentials. Like for example, some professor said that he was working on a particular area of research and he invited you to join him. What a great opportunity. Well, if I were in your place now, I would definitely go forward to analyze his scope of work and see if it's my area of interest, and I'll definitely reach out to him. Because normally, even in my case, I do not announce my area of expertise. I say I'm interested in research, but it takes time for somebody to find my area and network with me. I think I'm going to follow this the style of this professor. I forgot his name. Excuse me for that. He said his area of expertise, right? I specialize in English language teaching, and any of you, if you would like to work on a paper, maybe we can relate something with your architectural studies and something unique we can do and make a name for ourselves. So I take this opportunity to invite you. And while building your resume, remember, we all will have a name, a language, an address, a 12th standard pass and whatever. But what you have different in your resume is what is going to give you the job. So I have actually worked out a five finger strategy for you. And I would like to share with you. I've just taken a little effort so that you visualize. What I speak may not go into your heart, but I'm sure what you see, you will remember. So the first thing is about responsibility. You are here for whatever reason, but just try to be responsible for it. You are here. Be responsible for yourself. You will have the best of best, the bad of bad, anything available under the sun. But it's up to us to be responsible enough for ourselves. Like if it's going to be, for example, myself, Diana, yes, I'm responsible for my personal hygiene. I'm responsible for my diet. I'm responsible for my exercise. I'm responsible for my academics. I'm responsible for my overall growth. So the responsibility. And I would also like to share with you that we should always notice the, you know, our family members, because we are all, you know, products of heredity. And if somebody in the family is of suffering of a particular ailment, we should try to make a difference in our lifestyle. Our dieting and exercising should change. And the personality, which I would always emphasize as a personality trainer, the different, if you notice you're getting bald on one side of your hair, right, of your head, you need to change your hairstyle. You keep on combing the same hairstyle and you get bald. And what happens? You find your hair receding. You can't do much about it. So you have to increase, you know, nutrients in your diet. You have to take some extra care for your hair, change your hairstyle. These are simple observations which we can do for our personality growth outwardly. Well, each of us are beautiful in God's creation, right? So but how we maintain it, how you make it more better, lies in your responsibility. And the second one is G, which is a goal. So what is your goal? To complete this course and to be a proud alumni, okay, or a proud alumna, whatever. So for that, what is your goal? What are you going to work for? How are you going to make a difference? And if you plan to take up a job, just don't look for the banner of the company or the kind of salary. What is your contribution? Are you going to be important in the organization? Can you learn something from them? Can you cling on to them and slowly develop all the qualities that will help you to make a better brand for yourself? So what is your goal? So have that always in mind. And the third one is, I'm sorry. The third one is one more R. I know the formula by heart, so when I took the wrong flashcard, I could immediately tell you it's wrong. The third is a resume, which I've already touched upon. Try to make a difference. And always remember, your resume is your signature thing. You're going to place your signature on that. The moment you take the printout and you sign on it, you should be extremely proud of it. You are the artist of your resume. Use different colors, come out with different designs. You are architect, you are students of, you know, structural design course, and you'll be learning to do a lot of drawings, right? Consider your resume as a piece of art. Use different colors, different strokes, different, you know, stylings, different borders. I mean, I'm not referring to the typing part. I'm referring to what matters inside your resume, all right? So you are the artist of that masterpiece. And always see that your resume keeps growing. When you take a printout of your resume, you should always, oh, I never updated this workshop. I attended this workshop. Let me do it. Right? Every month, you should check on your resume. Don't let it just be idle. At the moment, you may be learning, languages, known two or three languages, or maybe some of us will know only one or two languages, mother tongue and English, of course. But take it from me. When you leave SRM, you should add at least one more language to your resume, one more skill. Everything is available in SRM. I say this as bit of my own experience here. And the fourth one, is B. So this is the brand. So what is Diana's brand? I'm Diana, for your information. My second name is Diana. So what is Diana's brand? What is Diana known for? Apart from my graduation and post-graduation and PhD. This is what I always keep on my mind. Likewise, each of you, call yourself by name, create your own brand. What are you known for? What are you specialized in? What do you give to the community? And my simple advice to you is, we all will be placed somewhere in the globe, somewhere. And we will all be doing well, hopefully, or eventually. But see that you contribute to the society. Go down to the areas where people can't afford to know what you know. Go there, visit them, teach them, train them, live in their hearts. Make memories, make a difference in those people's lives. You don't have to just go there and give a 10,000 rupees donation and make memory. No, that isn't memory. That's a momentous memory. That it's gone with that day's announcement or a week's announcement. That's it. But what you touch, who you touch, how you touch that is what matters. If you can go and visit orphanages and give them a training on your skills or whatever you expertise in, that will be remembered. Your time, the way you network, create an impact that somebody should desire to be like you. All right. And the last one of my formula is N, networking. I've already touched upon this. Try to, you know, meet people of varieties. Don't shun yourself. Don't curb yourself. Just go forward. And let me tell you, it's okay to make 1,000 mistakes as a student. You will be forgiven. You will be overseen. But once you get into your career role, your mistakes can be like, even a small mistake can be a mega disaster. And we get very sensitive and we may even have to change jobs at that point because we become too oversensitive as we grace with age. I say this out of my experience, right? I would have said 1,000 sorries as a student, but it really didn't matter. But if I'm to make a mistake and apologize now as an adult, as a maybe, you know, middle-aged adult, it's a bit sensitive for me because I take a time to reflect whether it's really my fault or the sorry is really required. Such kind of thinking processes happens in my mind. So what I'm saying is, when you're young, do it. You will be caressed eventually. You will be forgiven for whatever mistakes you made, but try to learn. Just as how you and me learn to eat so well without spilling the food. If you remember our childhood days, we would be spilling all over and running around and all this. But today you and me can handle our food so diplomatically well. It can be cycling, it can be swimming, it can be anything. So start networking. Being just a university student doesn't give us any much of a big qualification. What is the difference when you sit for placements? What is the difference you make? Let it be your style of dressing. Let it be the language you speak, the way you articulate, the mannerism you exhibit. All this is very, very important. And you can engage in even simple things, you know, like poetry writing, dance, everything. Everything is available at SRM. And I would like to share with you that this morning while I was reflecting on what to really tell you, because you are now my family, and I know how it feels on this special day one, I wrote a poem for you, and I would like to read it with your permission, please. Can I share the screen, please?
Yeah, one second.
Ma'am, you're the co-host, you can share the screen.
Oh. So while I'm, you know, sharing this, I would like to tell you that try to embrace your failures. Recently, I conducted a competition called the Failure Musing Award. And you believe it or not, I did not get more than 60 participants. People are not willing to come forward to share their failures. But always remember, your failures are the ones that actually help you to grow. And after much push, after much advertisements, we got 60 participants. And out of that, we've selected the winner. But I want to share with you that people are not open to share their failures. When you share your failure, it can be a learning to another person. It can be a learning to you in the first place. So never feel bad when you fail. It's an opportunity for you to perform better. We are now sharing the screen.
Ma'am, you can go full screen if possible.
Can you see?
We can see it, ma'am, but you can be able to do a full screen.
Ma'am, is it a video? Is it a YouTube video?
The YouTube will be played later. This is a Word document.
The Word document is not visible yet.
It's not visible.
Yes, ma'am, it's visible now.
That's it. Okay, I'm reading it out for you. College life disclosed. The curtain unlocks the grand beginning of college life. New campus, new friends, new style of learning and training. Newness all for you. Lifestyle, trends that lead to a newer version of you. There will be so much happening around you, in you, and through you. Some of you may be carefree and some overly busy and some make history. Classes, labs, clubs, cultural fest, tech fest, Wide too. Some underestimate you and some overdo you, but never worry because you don't have to be the version of their views. Stay focused on your goal. Participate in everything possible that helps growth. Blended learning, cutting across disciplines, is an art for you to explore. You will definitely enjoy the thrill as you fill your heart and mind. Make good memories, eat well, exercise, learn new things, plant a sapling, contribute to animal care, and above all, never shy away from anything that can make you a name to be appreciated or even just remembered. Soon, the curtain, the end of college life, will drop. It's a demanding world out there, and to have an edge over others, one needs to be the best of oneself. Good luck to you on becoming the better version of you, the masterpiece of you. So that was the poem which I actually put in place this morning when I was keeping you on my mind. So I welcome you all to SRM University, and I invite you to take some time off and find people of, you know, different interests so that you can find the newer version of you, the different version of you. Don't you think your parents would be extremely happy if you walk back home with a different skill? Let it be cooking, let it be, you know, learning a different style, let it be, you know, designing something new, writing a book, collaborating with people. Right? So SRM gives you everything, and I urge you to make the best use of everything. You will have a lot of opportunities to work with faculty, to intensively sit with them in discussions. And we have research faculty who separately, you know, are called as research track, where they specialize in research. So you can make it big. Trust me, it's just a matter of time and what you do in this beautiful campus. Sharing one more song for you. Can you hear?
It's not audible, ma'am.
Not audible. Yeah. Now?
Still not audible.
Not audible.
Ma'am, there will be an option called play with computer sound.
Oh, just a minute, ma'am. Just exploring this. Share with computer sound, that option. Audible?
Yes, ma'am. Can you make it full screen?
Yes, yes.
Please watch the lyrics.
It's mine.
I'm sorry, but I'm not able to hear the audio. Is it just me or is everybody able to hear?
My audio is feeble,
very low.
Oh, I see.
So it's your life. Make the best use of it. And remember, you are accountable. There will be many people who will tell, if you fail, people will tell you, I told her not to do it and see where she landed up. But even if you do something very well and they will say, yeah, I advised her at some point in life. So let's give them all the positive credit. Let's take a lot of positivity to your heart and soul and make the best use. And I hope you also walk out of SRM with a proud feeling as an SRMite. I am truly proud as an alumna of SRM. So once again, I remind you of the five finger formula, which is R, which is for responsibility, and G for goal, R for resume, B for brand. This is most important. This is what is going to give you, you know, your placement. This is what is going to make history in your life. Known, create your own brand, and N, network. You will find people of a variety, and you can find friends for life. You can find philosophers for life. So always remember this five finger formula, and don't forget the curtain of the college life is open right now. So what you do on stage is truly your performance, your capability. And soon the curtain will drop and you wake up one morning and you don't have to come to SRM. And so what next? The journey of life will continue. So SRM is, you know, a momentary place, a momentary station for you to build your beautiful castle. Your castle is your resume. All right? So young achievers, I call you young achievers with full confidence and pride that you are going to bring laurels to our institution, my alma mater, which will be your alma mater as well. So always remember that. Go down to the roots of the society. Give it free if you can afford. If you can travel free for them, don't charge them even for your travel. Go. Give more and you will receive. God's blessings will fall upon you each time you help someone in need. Share, be a butterfly. The moment someone sees you, they should say, so beautiful, so colorful, so wonderful, so outgoing. Imagine if there was a butterfly flying around now. Would you be looking at me? No, even I wouldn't be looking at this computer or all the pretty faces here. My attention would go to the butterfly. Be that butterfly. Be that beautiful butterfly of SRM. All right? So I also take this opportunity to thank the Dean of School of Architecture and Interior Designing, my wonderful colleagues of this beautiful department, and you young achievers for having had me today. It was extremely a proud moment for me to open up and share with you the most delightful things I had at SRM. And I wish that you too have this flowery road laid out, or the flowery carpet laid out for you. Take the best, make the best, and stay healthy, stay safe. Build in a lot of confidence in you. Every day is a new opportunity. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. My pleasure.
Thank you very much, madam. I'm really overwhelmed. I'm sure you rocked out like anything. You spoke from your heart. And we have seen you what you are actually. And I'm sure all these children would have enjoyed it. And I'm also, I also feel more excited after I hear you. It's amazing. It was excellent. We all feel butterflies flying all around here.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Very good. Excellent.
Thank you.
Keep motivating these children. You do a great job, And thank you so much for participating.
Yes, sir. I'm available. Amazing. I'm very much in the campus. We are young achievers. You can always connect with your dean, sir. I'll be happy to do a research paper with you, a poetry drama with you, or anything of an art and craft. Since I understand that you learn a lot of drawing, you will be learning. Why not us, we can collaborate and do something big. You are always welcome to approach us through your faculty, through your dean, sir. Welcome. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So nice of you. Good.
Can I may leave, sir, now?
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you very much, ma'am, for taking the time to join us today and for the lovely talk that was very motivational. Thank you again.
Thank you. Goodbye. Thanks.
So everyone, as we drop this session to a close, I would like to take this opportunity to thank you all for joining us today. And students, kindly note that the university orientation program is scheduled to begin at 11:15 a.m. Make sure you please attend that. And also join us back for the afternoon session at 1:15 p.m. Thank you. We'll now close the session.